Right, guys, how's it going? I hope some of you are able to get out casting and fishing. Lockdown is still happening in a lot of places. Fresh lockdown haircut, as you can see. That's the best thing about being a baldy. Number not all over, boom, no worries at all. But anyway, I'm going to talk about a few things tonight. Zeta Monomags. Upcoming World Championships, which is happening, hopefully, in August. And a wee rant probably about the price of second-hand things on eBay and stuff, reels. Ridiculous prices. So the first thing I'm going to do is get on to putting this monomag in this 5500. This is the same reel I tried out doing 150g casting. I quite enjoyed casting 150g on it, but the one thing I did notice was this is a 5500 now. Usually I would use 6500s for 150g casting. Because it's quite a small, narrower spool, the level drops very quickly. And you really have to be quick on the mags to keep it on the boil, I found. So I think I'll just go back to 6500s for 150. I'm going to use this for 5500s instead. Also, what I'm going to try to do as well to help out, I know there's a lot of South American guys watch the channel, Brazilian, Argentinian. I'm going to try to speak more slowly and clearly because I know sometimes people find it hard to understand my accent. Northern Irish accent. So let's get on to this 5500, see a bit more of it in detail. Okay, so as I said before, I did try casting 150g on this. This is 0.31. I'm going to change it over to 0.28. What I prefer to cast, a lot of my cast reels prefer to use dome sided end plates. For example, you can see this one here. Just with the dome, because it's slightly thicker than a flat-sided plate, you seem to be able to get a lot more travel compared to a flat-sided plate. It's a fair bit of travel, which means there's more chance of the magnet being basically full off. Now, there's a lot of talk on Facebook recently about stuff like how long do you need a reel to spin for. People are saying things from sort of like maybe a minute and a half up to 5 or 6 minutes. I tried recently, got a super duper set of bearings, put it in a reel and it spanned for 6 minutes. Went out to cast it. It was just about controllable, but I could hardly wind the mags off at all. I got them out a couple of mil just and started overrun, so it was quite hard to control. But having said that, there's nothing wrong with having a bit of extra travel if you need it. Maybe a very windy day and you actually do get the chance to wind the mags off fully. Why would you not take advantage of winding them mags off further away from the spool? So we'll see what difference it actually makes. Now, I've explained before in a lot of videos, the magnetic field strength is proportionate to the distance, inversely proportionate to the distance from the spool. So if the magnet moves twice as far away from the spool, you end up with 4 times less magnetic strength. If it was to move 3 times away from the spool, you'd end up with 9 times less magnetic strength. So that it actually, the curve drops off really quick. So that's why when you're winding off, with monomags especially, you get to the point it just seems to disappear. So we'll actually look at this in a bit more detail and see what happens. So I've already spun this reel with no magnet in it at all, just to see what it's like. You'll see here. Yep, guys, so there was the time with no monomag in, just the spool spinning on its own, 2 minutes 24, that's just for reference then. Okay, so taking this side plate off, it already has the 8mm hole drilled, just from the edge of the graduated ring, barely touching it. So what I like about the Zeta Monomags is, this is the bit that goes on the inside, so that goes there. Now what you find on a lot of Monomags is, it's a big fat nut there, and when this goes down in, it stops when it hits the nut. But the way Zeta have designed this, there's like a recess. So if you imagine that magnet's pointing towards the spool, and winding it off. Now on a lot of monomag systems, once that magnet got to there, it wouldn't travel any further. But because there's a wee recess there, I can screw that off in another good few mil. It was right down flat as far as it'll go, pretty much touching the inside of the side plate. So that's why I like to see the monomags. Right, so let's fit this thing and see what difference it makes between having a no mag in and having a mag. So it's very simple to fit these. You basically have a knob with an Allen key, shaft with a magnet, a spring, the inside thing, the inside collar, and the outside sort of boss that screws into this. So push the inside bit into the hole, take the outside collar. Now, if you're lucky, this will grip the side plate when you turn this, tighten this up, which it has done. Oh, sorry. Or you can use a screwdriver. It's fairly tight in there. Okay, so that's that fitted. So what have you guys been up to if you can't get out fishing? Or casting, I suppose. Most of you have hundreds and hundreds of rigs ready to go for when you can get out again. Over here in Northern Ireland, there's no tier system as such, like in the mainland UK, but we can go out fishing on our own, I think. Even with a friend, I'm not too sure, as long as you're social distance. So let's screw that right back in. So I'm looking forward to getting a new, nice, shiny set of side plates for this reel. So I can get a mint set of these side plates on eBay for about 30, 35 quid, like proper mint. But I did see today, and I couldn't believe my eyes, I did see someone selling 5,500 C3 CT Elite blue reels, complete reels, boxed. And he was I seen this today on eBay, he was looking £3,000 plus 50 postage. So good luck with the sale. I suppose they're worth whatever people are willing to pay for them. It just seems everything's gone up in price, like second-hand Ziplex rod bags. £35 rod bags are going for like 70, 80, 90 quid on eBay and stuff. Now, they're not always being sold for that. Sometimes people are bidding up to it, so there's definitely demand there because I don't think Ziplex makes them anymore. So you can see that there. That's it screwed out. The spring does get in the way very slightly of the mag retreating back into the recess, so I'm going to see if we can fix that a bit. What I'll do first is set this up and measure the amount of travel, and then I might modify it slightly. Okay, that's the side plate put back on in the free spool, and just wind this mag in until it touches the spool. You can just hear it touching the spool there. So what I do with all my monomags, different monomags come with different size strength magnets. I always just turn off half a turn, and that leaves me a bit of leeway. Let me just make sure the spool's nice and centered. Just do that again. Okay, half a turn. So what that does as well, when you put it back into gear, the pinion gear pushes against the spool. Sometimes what it does, I need a bigger desk, guys. Something's falling off left, right, and center here. So having that half turn just allows a wee bit of leeway from when you have it in gear with the pinion pushing across to the left. If you have a wee bit of play in the spool, sometimes it can rub against the mag. So that's the mag set in close. So let's take the side plate back on, off. Put the knob back on. Okay, that's the side plate back off. Our magnet's set in position close to the spool, but not quite touching it. Just hold the magnet. Screw the knob on. Don't let the shaft turn. Screw that down. So there we go. Let's just actually measure the travel on that at the moment. Let's call it 6 mil. Right, let's put this back on, spin, see how long it spins for. If it's anywhere close to no mags. Yeah, it's quite a nice wee reel that. Went for the grey because the Cage is kind of grey, and I will get a Abu Silvermax handle, which is like a curved Abu handle, very similar to the Accios handles. A new set of side plates, obviously. But anyway, mag full off. Let's see how long she spins for. So you might want to fast forward this. I'm sure it'll be close to 2 minutes. What I do is usually set that for... start the timer and start spinning at 5 seconds in. So let's do this. So you might want to forward, I don't know, at least a minute and a half if you don't want to see this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Sounds a wee bit noisy, but it's not too bad in real life. It's just because on the bench, it's not bad. Purring away nicely. Let's see how long she goes for. That's her starting to slow down a wee bit now. No fancy bearings in this, just steel bearings that have been cleaned out with a tiny bit of oil. So we're coming up to 2 minutes here. There we go, 2 minutes two, 2 minutes three. It's rolled back there, it might be out of balance, but it might just be the tape. So 2 minutes three. Now to me, 2 minutes three wasn't bad at all. I mean, no mag at all, it was 2 minutes 24, so it's only 20 seconds slower. Let's see if we can prove that a wee bit. Just to give you the option to wind it off a bit further if you want to. Right, so my side plate back off again. So with that fill off, it was only 20 seconds slower than the no mag at all. So I mean, there must be a tiny bit of magnetic strength affecting the spool still. So if we can get it out another, even another mill or two, you might find it drops off to pretty much nothing. It's the same as having no field strength at all. So we're going to have a look at this now. So even though there's a wee recess there, the spring gets in the way and doesn't allow that mag to go fully right back in. So what I'm going to do is take this all apart again. Take the knob off. Now sometimes I just do this as a matter of course, but I thought that I'd actually measure it and see if it does make a difference. I know it makes a difference in the amount of mag travel, but I'm not sure. I haven't measured it in terms of spool spin time. That's the mag off. Undo this inside bit. So, as you can see, that's quite thick there, but the mag should recess into that, but sometimes the spring stops it. So what I do, let's see how thick that is. That is about 4 mil thick. So I'm going to take about 2 mil off the inside of that just, and that's 2 mil extra travel. It'll allow the mag to screw out more to the left. Sometimes I bought second hand wheels, and this bit of metal, not necessarily Zeta monomags, other monomags, the bit of metal on the inside is just like paper thin, like tinfoil. So people have obviously done it for the same reason. So let's do that now. Just take a now. There's wee notches in that which helps to tighten it up, but I just hold it with the pliers. So I'm gonna rub this against a file for a minute or two. What I generally aim to do, I'm not recommending you do this, it's just what I do. I generally try to just file it down to get rid of those, the two notches on the edge. Get myself a file, make sure I don't wreck the place here. So we'll be back in a minute. Okay, after several minutes of frantic filing with a blunt file, you can see I've removed the wee notch from the side, so this is a wee bit thinner. It's down to about 2.5 mil. So I've probably gained a mil and a half. So hopefully when I put this back in, we'll have a bit more mag travel. So same routine again, put this back in, outside bit on. Hold that in place, tighten this up, which is it's going to be a bit harder grip because it's a bit thinner. Good and solid. Mono mag back in. Do the same again. Mono mag back in the whole way and put it back on the rail. Screw the side plate back on. Okay, the side plate back on. Check for play. Same thing again. Just screw it right in. Then half turn off. Take it off. Hold it in place. Put the knob back on. So I'll just skip that bit. I'm gonna take the side plate off. Hold the shaft in position, put the knob back on. Okay, hold it in place. Knob back on. And the bullet's falling out again. So hopefully when I screw this off, you'll be able to see it goes closer to the side plate. To me, it looks quite a bit closer. But you'll see it. I'll measure it here. What do we have travel we have before 6 mil? What do we have here? So around 7 there. Thought it would have been more, but just over 7. I think we'd had just under 6. So we've gained over a mil of travel, which might be enough just to dip it over the edge where there's hardly any effect on the spool at all. But the stopwatch will be the tell of that. So side plate back on again, guys. Right guys, let's spin this up. Mag's full off. Bit of play. Start the timer at 5 seconds in. Now obviously it depends how hard you spin it, but I try to be fairly consistent. Just do it as hard as I can. I don't know if I mentioned earlier as well, the last one with the standard mag, I did spin it, start at 5 seconds, so can you take 5 seconds off the time, which would make it 1:57, so whatever this is, take 5 off again. So let's see if I can beat it and get close to what it was with no mags. So if the clock goes past 2:02, that 1 mil of travel's helped a wee bit. Well, it's gone past it. By how much? Two 15. So in reality, that was 2:10. So we've gained about 13, 14 seconds there. So it's with that amount of travel, it's almost as good as having no mag. So to me, there's sufficient. This mag travel there that I'm not going to worry about at the end of the cast, the magnet's holding the reel back really. So hopefully you found this helpful. I mean, some Zeta mags are very good, come standard, also are Rocket Reel Company ones, but some mono mags have a big thick nut on the inside and you end up with like about, I've had some with about that much travel, like 3 or 4 mil, whereas here we have 7. So let's compare that to a domed one, just for comparison. You will get more travel on a domed side plate, obviously. Hopefully, if it proves me wrong here. Yeah, about 8.5 there. But I've just shown there, the Zeta Monomag with 7mm of travel, slight modification done to the inside, is near enough as good as having no mag at all. So, in that case, big huge wind, I'm just going to keep winding and winding and let that baby sing until the lead touches down. So hopefully that didn't bore you too much, guys. Just one of the wee tricks probably a lot of casters do. Makes fairly obvious sense, but you want that winding off, you want that mag as far away from the spool as possible. Alright guys, so just a wee small tuning chip there for you. Works for me. You don't need to do it for fishing or anything really, do you? But might give you a few centimetres, who knows. So World Championships is supposed to be happening again this year in Italy. It's going to be in August 21st, 28th. So I'm assuming it's going to be hot, humid, and I've heard the field is going to be near Pisa. Probably not going to be much wind around that time of year. So I'll have to get used to casting with no wind. Back on the training probably a wee bit. Well, I'm going to take it easy because it did hurt my shoulder in July. And it's only really better the last month or so. I think I've done a rotator cuff in or something, but it's feeling good and strong now. Back out smashing it, getting a new rod. My main rod is the Red TXL I use a lot in the videos, but I'll be taking the M427SU as well. Probably a new main rod and the red one will be back up, but who knows, I might prefer the red one, but just good to have sort of two the same. So that's the plan now. So I don't know if am I going to need a vaccine to travel. I'm going to need, what else do I need? Is it going to be on? So I just have to play it by ear and see what happens. So stay safe, guys. Hope you can get out casting and fishing soon. All the best.